Today, I will show you how to overclock a Broadwell E CPU on the X99 chipset. TestBench today will be using a ASUS Deluxe 2 and the Core i7-6900K. Okay, so first thing we're going to do is go into the BIOS. You will have to press Delete, F2 or Escape depending on your motherboard, but on the ASUS Deluxe 2 is Delete. Before we starting, I want to tell you that Broadwell E is not overclocking that high as Haswell E did, but it's performing a lot better with GHz. My Core i7-6900K at 4.5 GHz is performing the same or even better than the 5960X at 5 GHz, which is amazing. Okay, the first thing I'm going to do now is go into the advanced mode. So I'm going to press F7. Go into the AI trigger. The first thing we're gonna do is getting our RAM frequency properly set up. So I'm going and AI overclocking Turner and choosing ATP. So our memory is gonna running at 3 GHz, but I'm gonna change the CPU strap to 100 MHz, and then we're gonna go down to our DRAM frequency, as you can see here. Gonna change it to 3000 as my RAM is 3000 MHz, so yeah, it makes sense. Then we're gonna go down to DRAM voltage here. Mine requires 1.35 volts, so gonna set to 1.35. Now we can actually start with CPU overclocking. So I know for a fact that my CPU can do 45 GHz, 4.5 GHz, but in, yeah, normally air cooling or probably a high end water cooling would do 42 just fine. So we're gonna set to 42 and no doubt to CPU voltage. Fine. There you go. I would not recommend to go higher than 1.25 at 24/7 use. So I'm just gonna try 4.2 GHz. You might gonna change the voltage or do lower, even higher, depending on your overclock. I'm just gonna try 1.23 volts. Okay. So the next thing we're gonna do is just double check our voltage. Okay, let's find it. Okay, everything is fine, but I want you to change one thing. Okay, I wanted to change the VCC IO CPU voltage, because sometimes if you left it at auto, I see they just crank up the voltage crazy high. There's no need for that, and so we can just change it to the same as stock 1.05. Okay, so last thing we're gonna do now, it's the new fixture on X99. We have the case overclocking. Today, sorry, I'm a bit sick, so. But the case ratio is a new feature of the X99, or probably old now when you see this video, but you have to set it as high as possible. That means as close as you can get to your CPU ratio. But if you're running on Broadwell E, you can probably not go higher than 35, so we're just gonna leave it for 30 now, and have to do this first, 30, and the last thing we'll do is find the CPU case voltage. Stock is 1.09, so we're just gonna change it to 1.1, and well, there's nothing left to do. 4.2 GHz, everything is set up. See here, 4.2, case frequency is 3 GHz, and my RAM is 3 GHz. So, F10, and let's see if it's going to boot up or it will crash. is booting! What a surprise, or... well... something. Just want to mention that for stress test, I'm gonna use IDA 64. But you can use Prime 95 too. It's a free program you can use and download. I would probably say just only have to stress test with CPU 1 to 6 hours to see if it's 100% stable. Now I'm just gonna wait for the Windows to load. Okay. So we're gonna start it, gonna open CPU set to see if we got the right frequency and our program IDA 64. Okay, and oh, I almost forgot, we're gonna need Cortan 2. Okay, as you can see, CPU is running 4.2 GHz at 1.23 volts, as exactly as we did, and our RAM is running at 1.5 frequency. You have to 1.5 is 3 GHz, as it's divided by 2. Okay, so anything is fine. I'm just gonna go into the tools, system stability test, and we'll start. And now see the CPU is spiking at 4.2 GHz, 100x42, and the CPU is running at 53 degrees, 57, well, it's running at about 55 degrees all the time. It's, my computer has been running all day, so it's kind of high temp right now, but it's summer, well, it's really hot. Well, I have nothing more to say now. If you want to try and get a higher overclocking than this, just try to raise the multiplier to 43 and keep it at the same voltage until it's unstable, and then want to slowly crack the voltage up. If you want to know more about overclocking or anything else, so leave a comment below. If you have any idea about a video you want to see, probably, well, just anything, let me know in the comment, and thanks for watching, like and subscribe.